Thank you, madam. Namaste to all the participants, especially respected teachers and my dear students. It's nice to see all of you with those smiling faces looking at the screens, and I want to enjoy some birds. So thanks to DAV school and all the teachers, principal ma'am, sir, for organizing this webinar for selected students. I know all of could not be attended. All could not be taken into this particular webinar. What I will do is I'll just start with the presentation rather than speaking extempore. So let us enjoy the birds. I will take you through some birds, but get ready with your chat also, because I will ask some questions. And the jewels, flying jewels of nature, those are the birds, beautiful birds. So let me thank Tata Motors, and which is supporting Bombay Natural History Society under the Vasundhara project for conducting these webinars. And we have decided to reach out to students like you throughout India. So birds, there is a bird known as emerald dove, which is shown here. And if you know what is an emerald, it is really a flying jewel. And these are the wings of two birds. And this part particular, which shines like a jewel, is known as speculum. So when these birds are flying very high through the clouds, they can see the shining speculum and understand that, yes, the birds of my flock are flying along with me, because this will shine in those clouds. So the birds are flying jewels. But why they are flying jewels? Because they are precious, more precious than jewels. And I will start with a question. And the question is, what are the two most important places in Odisha? That is, you know, your own home state. And I want those two places to be about birds and wildlife. So can you type in the chat so that I can read? I can read your answers. I know all the students of DAV are very talented, and this is a very, very simple question. Still, I would like to start with the question, because that makes it more interesting. Bhuvaneshwar and Katak, Chilika Bird Sanctuary. Yes, Sri Sikta is correct. One answer I got, which I was looking at, Chilika Bird Sanctuary. Bhitarkanika, wow, that's great. So Odisha, it seems, has many, many places. Nandankanan Zoo, very nice. Oh my God. So Odisha has got so many places. Chilika. Gair Mata, yes, who is that? Yeah, you're too smart. Gair Mata, I love it. Chilika again. Yes, second Chilika National Park. Yes, of course, it is the same extension of this Chilika. Yes, Gair Mata, Bhitarkanika, so many places, nice places in Odisha to come and visit. That's why Satkoshia Tiger Reserve, yes, to see the tigers. A lot of people from around the world are coming to Odisha to see the tigers. Many, many people coming to see the Chilika. Yes, Bharatpur Bird Sanctuary is not in Odisha. Okay, but it is a very good place in India, and a lot of people are coming to India to see the birds in Bharatpur. That's a beautiful place. Nandankanan Zoological Park. Yes, most of you are right, except Bharatpur. Okay, no issues. Okay, let us look at some of those places. And this is the one Gair Mata, as some of you mentioned, and I really appreciate your knowledge. This is a place where the olive ridley turtles make their nests in hundreds and hundreds. Oh, not in hundreds, thousands. They make nests in thousands, and this is the only place in the world where this type of congregation of the turtles occur. Nowhere in the world you can see so many turtles at one place making their nests and their babies coming out in hundreds. No, not in hundreds, thousands and lakhs. They come out and they go back to the sea. So the famous places, yes, there are many in Odisha, I know. And I could not visit all of them, but Gair Mata Beach and Chilika, these are the best places, famous places which I love. And I could visit Chilika, and of course Chilika also has one park. The northern part of the Chilika Bird Sanctuary is known as Mangala Jodi. So let me talk about Mangala Jodi, because we are talking about birds. This is how you see birds in Chilika. Of course, the camera cannot accommodate each and every bird, because there are 10 lakh birds in Chilika. 10 lakh birds, you must go if you haven't visited Chilika. Next time you plan for a picnic, you must plan for Chilika. And the Mangala Jodi is only 75 kilometers, not more than 100 kilometers from your house, wherever you stay in Bhubaneswar. So this is a small village, Mangalajudi, and this is on the northern side of the Chillikal Lake, and there are only odd 100 odd families and 500 people staying in this village. Why I'm talking about this place known as Mangalajudi? It is, my dear friends, it is an excellent place to visit, to see the birds. Not only to see the birds, but it is summer. It is an excellent example of something else. There was a person who was known as the Virappan of Odisha, and his name is Kishore Behra. And he was like a very dangerous person. So that was in, and he spoke Odia, and that was in 2000. And he was famous poacher. That means he used to kill lots and lots of birds, like 1,000 birds. And he will not listen to anybody. He will threaten to everybody, and he was a very dangerous person. So many others did the same in the village because they wanted to earn money. So what was this choice? Because Mangalajudi got thousands and thousands of birds. What do? They just kill and sell it, so get money. So that was the only way they thought the life should go on. And what happened next? Next, there came a person known as Nandakumar. Nandakumar Bhujbar. So he went to our Virappan, and he said, please stop hunting the birds. They are the flying jewels. Just like I am telling you, they are the flying jewels and you are listening. So will Kishore Behra listen to him? So Nandakishore tried to tell him, you will earn more money by keeping the birds alive rather than killing these birds. And our friend said, get out of my village or I will kill you. Don't tell me all these things. I know how to earn money by killing birds. It is so easy. But Nandakumar Bhujbar, when he said, get out of my village and I will kill you, he asked him, when will you kill me? Kishore Behra said, if you show your face in my village tomorrow morning, I will kill you. And what happened next day? The next day morning, Nandakishore sir went to the village again and was standing in front of Kishore Behra's house in the morning. When Kishore Behra came out, he said, you are still here? And Nandakishore said, yes, you said you are going to kill me. So I am here so that you can kill me. And then Kishore Behra was like, oh my God, what is happening? Who is this crazy fellow? Why is coming? And he said, what do you want? He said, oh, I want you to stop killing these birds. He said, that gives me money. He said, you will get money. You will get respect. You will get more money. Thousands of people will come to your village and they will appreciate Kishore Behra. Not only that, everybody will remember Mangalajudi. Listen to me. I'm not going to harm you. I'm not going to call police or the forest department. Let us work together. So what was the situation at that time? The birds feared coming to Mangalajudi because they killed so many. So at that time, there were 5,000 birds in those swamps and people were killing many of them. Now, what is the situation after 20 years? There are 1 lakh to 3 lakh birds in the village. And in that time, nobody wanted to visit Mangalajudi for seeing birds. Everybody wanted to visit to buy fish. Now thousands of people visit Mangalajudi for seeing birds. And that is known as bird tourism. Everybody pays for the small canoe or the small boat in which they go around and see those beautiful birds with binoculars and take their pictures with cameras. Because now birds are no more frightened to human beings. The birds know that these are our friends and the birds won't fly even if you go near to their nest. And how much money the people earn? The village earns at least 50 lakh rupees. But this is a very old figure. That is at least 5 years back. Now the village gets crores of rupees because all these bird watchers will pay. We'll pay for the bird trip in the canoe for staying in a house in the village. And for the food, local food, which food? That also I will say, tell you. And what do these local people carry now in their boats? They carry bird books and don't carry any gun or don't carry any bird traps to catch the birds. But they carry the Salim Ali's Book of Indian Birds and they carry a pair of binoculars to see the birds and to show to the visitors. And this is how people come and visit the Mangalajudi. They enjoy the birds and these are the local people who get money. And they show the birds and now you see how many people are there, how many boats are there. Everybody looking for those beautiful birds around. And there are thousands and thousands of birds flying around you and you enjoy the you enjoy the birds. And you can see a bird nest here, and the canoe is just passing from nearby, and there is a nest, and the people enjoy seeing birds' nests and birds. Now there is an organization known as Mangalajudi Ecotourism Trust, which tells the people how to behave. The well-managed tourism, that means nobody disturbs the bird or kills the bird or takes the egg. And instead of exploiting the birds, like killing the birds and eating them or selling them, if you keep the birds alive, the birds are giving them money every year for so many years, for thousands of all those 500 people, and the entire village has become rich. If you go in winter when there are lakh birds in the swamps, there is no place for parking in the village. That is the amount of people come to Mangalajudi to see the birds. So what they have done, they have helped, you know, to conserve, to save the wetland and to save the birds. And not only that, they also do the fishing. So they also get the fish, but they don't use any bad methods. They use their conventional or traditional methods which were used by their grandfathers. So it catches only the fish which they want. So it does not harm any other animals like the turtles are there or whatever. So you can see Kishore Behra here making the fish net. And dried fish, of course, I know many of you must be loving sukhya bhaja. So they dry the fish with their conventional methods, and the fish comes to market. And this is Mangalajudi Ecotourism, and this is like a resort which has come up in the village, and there are many like these which are developed by Mangalajudi Ecotourism Club, and you can stay in these huts, pay the money which will go to the local people, and they don't kill the birds, and they will give you nice food including the sukhya bhaja, and you can enjoy the local food. And there are now many foreigners coming to this place to see the birds. This lady came from Guyana. Okay, this is the hut, beautiful hut with beautiful paintings and made from simple soil and cow dung and grass, where you can stay and enjoy the birds and go out for bird watching. Now let us see a small video. I hope it works. It's only 2 minutes. Okay, that was about Mangalajudi, and I hope you liked it. So let's go. Let's have a look at birds. The topic for today's presentation. So what is a bird? That is always a very interesting question. So is this a bird? Again, okay, let's go to chat. And you have to tell me whether I'm going in the right direction. Okay, this is not a bird. Okay, this is not a bird. Okay, now next I will show. Is this a bird? Because it can fly. This is a flying snake. No, again no. Okay, this one, it can fly. Oh, it's a bat. This is not a bird. Yes, one somebody said yes. Satyajit. And this Batman, is it a bird? Again no. Bat is a mammal, it's not a bird. Okay. This is a duck-billed platypus. It has got a beak. So is it a bird? Again, they have a beak and they can swim. Again, no. Okay, you're all correct. I think the questions are very easy. This is a butterfly. It can fly. It has got wings. Is it a bird? Batman is a superhero. Yes, it is not a bird. Oh, butterfly is also not a bird. Okay. Penguins, they cannot fly, but they have feathers. Is it a bird? Penguin, is it a bird? Or is it a fish? Yes. Everybody is saying yes. I think the students are too intelligent. Okay, one more. Ostrich, they also can't fly. Are they birds? Are they elephants or what? Ostrich is also a bird, but they can't fly. Penguin is also a bird, but they can't fly. Yes, it is a flightless bird. So, right. Ostrich is a bird. So, even if they can't fly, they are birds because they have feathers. Okay. So, I think we are going towards the definition of a bird, and not too difficult. So, they have feathers. Is this a bird? What about these two cute birds? Oh, these are birds. And what is the ODI name? What is the name? Yes, Pecha. So everybody knows Pecha is an owl. Okay, so these are spotted owlets and these are birds because they can fly and they have feathers. So what will be the definition of a bird? So they have two legs. They have no scales. Scales are there on snakes. Scales are there on butterfly wings. They don't have ears like us. They have bill and beak. But platypus does have a bill or a beak, but it is not a bird. Can they fly? Yes, birds can fly, but no, it is not a necessary qualification to become a bird. So even if they can't fly, but if they have feathers, they are birds. So animals with two legs and feathers are birds. So that's a simple definition. Wow, so nice answer. Pritam, so huge answer. Warm-blooded vertebrates having a body covered with feathers, four limbs modified into wings, scaly legs, a beak, and no teeth, and bearing young in a hard-shelled egg. Wow, that's a perfect definition. But it looks like if you haven't copied it from internet, if you are not copying from Wikipedia, this is very good. Abhishmita and Pritam, if you are not copying from internet, these are very nice, very well written. Okay. So now I am asking you a very nice question. Next question is, what do you know which bird chicks are quickly able to stand and walk on their own as soon as they hatch or are born from the eggs? What are the birds? So can you name some of them? Oh, Ronak, hen. You said hen. Ostrich, hawks. Hawks is not right. Hen. Owls, no, not owls. Hen, duck, chickens, yes, hen, ostrich, duck, kiwi, these are all right, all poultry, perfect. Duck, kiwi, duck, ostrich, hen. So these are the birds in which the chicks, as soon as they hatch out, they start walking. This is very interesting, very interesting. Turkey, very interesting, okay. So these are all the birds in which the chicks start walking as soon as they hatch. So this is a peacock or peafowl, this is a peahen, and these are the chicks. And this is of course, our poultry chicken, and the goose, ducks, turkey, and all the birds which make, most of the birds which make their nests on the ground, as soon as they hatch, they start walking. So if there are four eggs, all must hatch at the same time. Otherwise, what will happen? The first baby will start walking on first day, and the second on second day, where will the mother look after the first baby or the eggs? So all the eggs hatch on the same day. So all the babies come out on the same day and they start walking with the mother. But there is something more interesting about this. So these are the birds like ducklings, lapwings. These are well developed when they hatch and quickly able to stand and walk. And some wild birds which make nests on the ground, they are so much camouflaged like these lapwing chicks that you may trample them and the birds may die, but you can't see them. It's so difficult. They are so much camouflaged with the background. This is a hen. And do you see something very interesting in this image? Anybody can feel what is the interesting thing in this photograph? You can type. How many legs it has? Chickens? No, nobody's writing. Anything interesting here? Baby peacock. Wow, Mamita. Yes, so it has got how many legs? Here you can see six legs. So there are two more babies hiding here and one baby here. And this is not a chicken. This is a peacock baby or peahen baby. Okay, so there are three chicks here and this is a peahen. This is our domestic hen. So what this person has done, he brought the peacock eggs and put under the hen for incubation. And when the babies came out, the babies don't know that we are peacocks or peahens. They think that this hen is my mother, so they start walking behind the hen. And even if they go, they become big peacocks and with big beautiful feathers, they don't know that I am a peacock. So they just think I am a hen and they behave like hen for their entire life. And you might see some peacocks roaming in some villages if you go travel around. Okay, there is one more interesting thing. And when the chicks come out from the hen's eggs, if you have a toy hen like this with a cord, you put it near the chicks, remove the hen, and move this hen in front of the chicks. The chicks don't know who is their mother. Now they think that this hen, this toy, is their mother. And you pull the string and they start following this hen. They think this is their mother. So that is how the hens understand. So the chicks don't know who is their mother, and whatever moves first in front of them, they think that is their mother. So this toy becomes their mother. Isn't it interesting, boys and girls? Okay, now tell me, do you know which bird chicks are naked, blind, and helpless when they hatch and are born? Can you give some example? One example was already given in the previous answer, which was wrong there. Now it is correct here. So what is that? What can you give me some examples? Very common birds around you. I don't want very rare birds. Eagle, oh, owl, parrot, sparrow. You all smart boys and girls. Ox, not chicken, huh? Chicken was the answer for the previous one. Sparrow, yes. The cute little sparrow, where, everywhere. Oh, somebody's writing in Odia, I can't read. Okay. Kiwi, not kiwi again. Kiwi was the answer for the first time. Okay, you are all right. Crow is also correct. Okay, so you are all right. So these are the birds in which every day, what happens here is every day one chick hatches as per the laying sequence. If the egg is laid on the day one, the chick will also hatch on the day one. And so the first day chick will be bigger and the last day chick will be younger or smaller. So what happens here? The chicks need considerable care, parental care, before they can stand, walk, and survive on their wing, on their own. So the mothers have to take a lot of care. The mothers sit on the chicks because the chicks are naked. They are to maintain the body temperature. And the examples which we have given is all right. Those are these birds, and those are also known as passerine birds. Okay, so all your answers are correct. So this is just fun. Okay, what category you will put yourself if you were a bird chick, bird baby? We are not birds. Okay, the first category are like a hen, or the second category like a sparrow. So can we, as soon as you are born, you can walk? Or your mother has to take care of you for 1 year and then you start walking? Now two is coming. Second category, okay. But we are not birds, okay. This is just for fun, okay. Just for fun. Yes, our mother takes care of us so much. And then our teachers, they will teach us about reading, how to read Oriya, how to read English and Hindi, and how to read books. And so much of training goes for making of a smart kid, smart school boy, like a school girl like you. It needs so much effort from your parents and from the teachers. Okay, there is one bird which doesn't know what is his mother tongue, how their parents speak, like the rose ring parakeet and the parakeet or the shua. What happens with this? The boys climb the trees, they know the nest, and they just take out the chicks of the parakeets and they bring home because they like the parakeets, because they talk so well. But the parakeet chicks, which are very young, they don't know how their parents speak. So when they are brought and put in a cage, they start speaking like us because they just mimic you, because they don't know what is their mother tongue. So they learn. For example, if there is a small 1 year boy and we send him to America, he will speak English. He won't speak Odia if every kid around him is English. Just like that, the parakeets also don't know what is their mother tongue. And they start mimicking, and because of mimicking, all the many parakeets are put in jail, in the cages. This is so sad for the parakeets. Okay, so that's why if somebody mimics others, they are known as parrots, tota, and it's not considered good. Okay, so there are many birds which are very, very beautiful, like this oriental dwarf kingfisher, so many colors on its body. So that's why people die to see these, that they spend so much money to see those beautiful birds. They travel all around. People from many countries come to India, to Arunachal Pradesh, to Odisha, to Chilika, to see those beautiful birds, those so many kingfishers, so many flamingos in India. birds are, some birds are very big, some birds are very small, like the saras crane, as tall as me, 5 to 6 feet tall, and such a tiny bird. This is a, this is not a hummingbird, this is a sunbird. This is less than 10 centimeters. Just look at how the size of the sunbird will be compared to the saras crane. Actually, I have shown it slightly bigger because you may not be able to see the sunbird if I show it in the real sense. So we have in India, the huge bird like the saras crane and the small bird like a sunbird. And how many species are there in India? Such a huge country with so many different habitats, from wetlands, the Himalayas with snow, the desert, the beautiful forests of Himalayas, the beautiful forests of Western Ghats, and beautiful wetlands and swamps like Chilka. So we have got so many types of birds, desert birds, Himalayan birds, birds in colder areas, birds in water, so many. So we have got more than 1,300 types of birds. And but there are so many interesting things about birds. Okay, the bird, the bones of birds are not like our bones. Our bones are so strong, they won't break very easily. But the bones of birds are very, very hollow and are filled with air, so that it becomes very light for the bird to fly. If I want to fly, my bones has to be hollow. It's not possible. It is not possible. It will break very easily. So I can't fly without the support of a machine. The skull bones are like very thin, like paper, but they are combined together to protect the brain, because they have to fly in very fast, sometimes may bang their head on something. And birds can move their neck through 180 degrees, not 360 degrees. But there is a bird which can rotate their heads to 360, not 360 degrees, but 270 degrees without breaking their neck. And those are the owls, and those owls are known as pechay, as you said. So I'm writing here, and this is a barn owl. So let us see something interesting. And one more thing, interesting thing about birds. Birds don't have teeth. They might be beautiful like the auntie, but they don't have teeth, but they have serrations like this, because teeth are very heavy. If birds have teeth, their head will become very heavy, like we have so much heavy teeth. Okay, that is also an interesting fact. So if you want to identify a bird, there are a lot of things you need to observe. When you go out, just go out around your house, or in the backyard, or in the school garden, wherever, you need to observe where you are, what is the distribution. Means look at the book, size and shape of the bird, the color of the bird, behavior of the bird, and also listen to the bird calls. Because not all birds, if you go to a dense forest, you won't see all birds coming out and just standing in front of you. Take my picture. They will be all hiding, because they think you might kill them. So they will all be hiding. So what you need to do, you need to listen to their language. You need to, because every bird speaks a different language, and that is known as the bird call. They are all different. And from the calls also, you can identify many types of birds in dense forests. And there will be bird guides who can identify 100 birds just by listening, just by their ears. They are so sharp in listening to the bird calls. Like, I'll talk about, just look at the size. House sparrow is a tiny bird, no? Compared to the crow and compared to the pigeon. So they are bigger in size. So when you talk about sizes, you need to compare the bird sizes. And sometimes when you are observing birds, you are always mesmerized by the colors. And you need to write down, if you are not taking pictures, you need to write down what is the color. Such a beautiful color of this golden oriole bird, and a beautiful blue and orange color of the common kingfisher. So different colors. So there are birds with many, many colors in the nature. And the shapes of the beak, it depends on whatever food the bird is eating. The shape of the beak determines what the bird is going to eat. Like the crow, see, look at the strong and long beak of the crow, an insect-eating bird, and the grain-eating bird, the conical beak of the grain-eating bird, and the nectar-feeding sunbird or hummingbird is very thin beak with curve, and a strong and straight beak of a woodpecker, like that. So there are many types of beaks in birds which define and which determine what the bird is going to eat. Let us have a look at some birds which feed on grains, vegetarian birds. You can say that. So this is our very common bird which stays around our house, and that's the house sparrow. And what do you call a house sparrow in Odia? Can somebody type? Chatia, yes, Gara Chatia. Yes, yes, right. Gara Chatia. So house sparrow, very nice name. Very simple name, Gara Chatia. So the males and females are very different, and these are the birds we stay around our houses. And let us listen to this. This is known as the dawn chorus of the house sparrows. So they all the sparrows roost in one tree, like 100, 200, 500 sparrows come and sleep in one tree. And early in the morning, they start chirping. And this is known as their chirping or dawn chorus of the house sparrows. Have you listened to this? Or there are no sparrows in Bhuvaneshwar? Anybody has listened such beautiful noise in the morning? I will take questions in the end, okay, so that won't disturb my flow of presentation, okay. So there are many among you who are lucky and you have listened to this beautiful music of the house sparrows. I have recorded this so I can hear and listen whenever I want. I can play it in my mobile. Yes, those who have listened is really, I will say you. So are the sparrow numbers going down or declining? Everybody was thinking that because of the mobile towers and because of the radio waves, the number of sparrows is going down. But a report has come down which says that the population is not really going down. But in some places it's going down. In some places it's stable or constant. So not to worry much about the number of sparrows. But it depends on where you are. If you are in a village, the number of sparrows around you will be more. If you are in a very, very big city where there is no greenery, there are no trees, might be the number of sparrows will be less. But of course, they haven't died. They are just around the corner, okay, wherever they have greenery. They just shifted from one place to another. So rural housing provides good nesting places, and urban housing, there is no place for them to nest because we have all glass windows. There is no place for them to enter your house or make a nest behind a photo frame. There is no place. So that's why you may not see them around your house. And yes, there is a confusing bird which looks like a house sparrow, and that is known as yellow-throated sparrow. And it has got a yellow throat patch like this, but it looks like a house sparrow. And there is another bird which again looks like the house sparrow. This female looks like the house sparrow, and this is known as bi-weaver bird. This is a beautiful bird and makes one of the most complicated nests in the world. And this nest, and the beautiful thing is the male makes a nest, and the females come around and see the nest, and if she likes the nest, then only she makes him her partner. Okay, otherwise no, otherwise she rejects him. You make a beautiful nest for me, a good home, otherwise then only I will marry you, otherwise I won't marry you. That's the simple formula. And that's why the most smartest or beautiful looking bi-weaver, and the smartest means the one who can build a beautiful nest, only gets a wife, otherwise no. So this is the male bi-weaver making a nest, and the female bi-weaver doesn't look as handsome as the male. So this was the situation, and this is still the situation in villages, but wherever the trees have been cut and the power lines are there, the bi-weavers are making nests even on power lines. So that is the situation. I have seen this type of nest in many places. So the house sparrow, the bi-weaver, and the yellow-throated sparrow, these are the three females, and these look very, very similar and very confusing to a new bird watcher if you are starting bird watching. But those are different birds, okay. There is one more bird which eats grains, and that's known as munia. And it's very small, it's a tiny, tiny bird, and people used to keep in cages, and there was a song also, Munia Re Munia, long back. I don't know whether any of you have heard this song, because it is an old generation song. So such a beautiful Munia. You can see the beak, it's conical and very short and very strong. That means it can crush the grains very easily. And this is a baby or juvenile scalybreasted munia, so different from the mother. There is one more munia known as scaly, silver bill munia or Indian silver bill. So the beak is silvery colored again, but the food is, and these are very tiny birds and were sold in cages in bird markets illegally long back. Now it is illegal, so not many people are selling these birds today. And our favorite bird, which is found in cities and the numbers are increasing. And that's the pigeon. And what do you call pigeon in Oriya? Kabutar. Kabutar is the Hindi word. I don't know what do you call in Oriya. Para, yes. And in Marathi, we call parwa. So nice. So nice, para. So the number of pigeons is increasing in cities because people feed pigeons with grains. They think it is punya. So they will go to heaven if they feed the pigeons. But the pigeons are bringing in lot of diseases and especially the lung diseases. People are finding it difficult to breathe because pigeons carry a lot of infections on their body, in their feathers, because their nests are very dirty. They don't know how to keep the nest clean. But as ma'am was telling me, that you guys are very, 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 very clean, and you keep the areas around your house and your rooms very clean. I believe, ma'am, that you are keeping your rooms clean. But this pigeon doesn't know how to keep its nest clean. It is very dirty. So it has got a lot of infestation. So it's not good to have a pigeon nest in your window. That's why in Mumbai, the government has banned feeding pigeons, but people still feed pigeons because we Indians are like that. That is what people say. They don't listen to government. But it's not good. Then we have a bird which looks like pigeon, but it's not a pigeon and it is smaller than pigeon. And this, when it, its call is like as if it is laughing. And that's why it is known as laughing dove. There is another bird which is known as spotted dove, which again looks like the laughing dove, but is not the laughing dove and has got a different color and a beautiful black and white chestnut board like patch here on its neck. So this is the laughing dove and this is the spotted dove. Have you seen the laughing dove at least in Bhubaneswar? I hope it is there. This one, it makes nest in your houses, in the windows, even on fan. It will make nest in the houses. And spotted dove is found in the forest. Okay, little bit of scrub forest. Okay, let us move on to the next. That is the fruit eating birds. So these are the birds which loves fruits. So these are the figs of the banyan tree or the bergat, kaped. This is papaya and these are oranges. Aren't these oranges? Beautiful oranges on this tree. I love oranges. So can birds eat oranges? Oh, it's a mango. Oh, sorry, these are mangoes. So mangoes are very tasty and fruit eating birds like parakeets know how to eat mangoes. Okay, these are mangoes. And then we have yellow-footed green pigeon. So this is the national bird, state bird of Maharashtra. And this is a 100% fruit-eating bird. So it feeds on the banyan pigs or people pigs and also feed on any other small berries which are there on the trees. And this is a green-colored bird, so you can't see it very easily. And sometimes there are so many in the tree canopy, you don't know that there are so many birds. And at one time you find 100 birds are flying. So it is very much camouflaged. Then I spoke about the rose ring parakeet. Everybody loves the parakeet, but many people love them in cages, which is not good. And the male have a beautiful necklace. You can see here, the female is not having the necklace. So that's the difference. That's the difference between a male and a female. And they don't speak human language. They mimic because they don't know what is their mother tongue. So don't think they are very, very talented birds. They just try to learn the language which their parents speak, just like we learn our language, whatever our parents speak. Because you have learned Oriya, I have learned Marathi. Then when we went to school, we learn Hindi, we learn English. Okay, just like parents. Then we have one huge parrot or parakeet that is known as Alexandrine parakeet. And it is very huge. And when it calls, it's very harsh, like raw, raw. And this, again, you can see beautiful color and beautiful red patch on the shoulders. So the male is more beautiful. In birds, in most of the species, the males are very beautiful and the females are not so beautiful, unfortunately. Many will not like this, but it is true. And diplomated parakeet. Okay, again, the male Male has got a beautiful plum head and a red patch here, whereas the female is has got this slaty head and yellow beak. And they make very, I will say, not the calls are not harsh. It's tweet, 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 tweet like that. And they fly very fast. There is one more bird, very tiny bird. You may hear the call, but you may not see. The call is just like two, 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 two. And that's known as Coppersmith Barbet. And it's there in all, most of the cities. It must be there in Bhubaneswar, and it loves eating fruits. And that's known as Coppersmith Barbet. There's one more bird, very interesting bird, which is there in cities. And it must be there around your houses. And that's the quail, Asian quail. So Asian quail, the male is black with the red eye, and this is the female with black and white dotting. So the male and female look very different, and these are very, very talented birds. And they are very good singers. Sorry. And they are very good singers. Let us see how the male sings. So have you ever heard? Have you heard this call in Bhubaneswar around your house? And so that was the melodious call of the male. Now female. This is the female. Not so sweet. Okay, there is something about this is, it is a, so this bird is a brute. Male is still calling. So this bird is a brute parasite. In the sense, the quail never makes any nest. What it does is it lays its eggs in the nest of a house crow or a jungle crow. And the jungle crow becomes the host, and they take care of their babies. So this is a house crow. And you might have heard stories that crows are very intelligent birds, but the quails make them fools. And the crows feed on the quail babies. But the quail chicks don't learn the language of the crows like the parakeets. And the quail chicks know that they are quails. And when they fly away from their foster parents, that is the crows, they start singing like the quails and not like the crows and not don't cow. Okay, so that's very interesting thing about the Asian quails. Okay, there are many birds which are brood parasites, especially in the cuckoo family. And they are all intelligent like that. Among the fruit-eating birds, I love this bird. This is known as hornbill because it has got a horn on the bill or on the beak. This horn is also known as casque or cusk. Most beautiful and most interesting thing about this is the female seals herself inside the nest cavity in a tree with mud and leaves only a small slit through which the male has to feed. So for 2 months, 3 months, 2 months, the female stays inside with and it lays eggs. The eggs are incubated. The eggs are incubated. The chicks hatch, and the chicks become bigger. Then the female comes out. Okay, but and all these days, the male takes care of them, brings food and everything for them, vegetarian, non-vegetarian, so that the chicks grow well. So this is very nice. So just like we did in Corona, we stayed inside the houses because the hornbill wants the safety of their babies. So the male don't want them to come out. So the females and the chicks stay inside till the chicks are grown and they can fly. And when they come out, the day one, they fly. Okay. Then one more category of very interesting birds. And these are nectarivorous birds or nectar eating birds. And do you know what are these birds? Can you type what are these birds? Oh my God, so fast. Cute, you are cute. Everybody is saying hummingbirds. Yes, yeah, hummingbirds are not found in India, but everybody is familiar with hummingbirds. It's so good. Look at their beak, no? Thin, pointed, slender, and slightly curved. Just like the shape of the flower. The flower shape and beak of these birds evolved together. That means thousands of years before, when the flowers were also developing and these were birds also there, they were both evolving, they evolved together and they decided that I will eat the nectar of this flower, and the flowers decided that my nectar will be given to hummingbirds. So they became similar to each other. So they became friends. So they are very fast friends. Let us see what are their similar birds. Okay, that's how the tongue of a hummingbird is used and is modified so that it can sip the honey from the tiny flower, from a honey feeder. We have similar birds, and we don't have hummingbirds in India. Hummingbirds are found only in Americas, that is North America and South America. And they are not found anywhere in the world, but we do have sunbirds, which are very similar, and that's an excellent example of similar or parallel evolution, also known as sunbirds. So these sunbirds, you can see the beak is totally immersed in the flower, and the beak again is just like the shape of this flower. And this is a purple-rimmed sunbird, and a beautiful male feeding on the flowers. But they occasionally take insects because their honey is not the only thing they need. And the female is not so beautiful, as I mentioned. Then we have the purple sunbird again. These two sunbirds are very common in India. And besides eating the nectar, what they do, they carry the pollen grains from one flower to another flower. And they do something which is very important, that is known as cross-pollination. And these are the ladies. You just saw the males, and these are the females. So the purple-rimmed sunbird female looks like this, and the purple sunbird female looks like this. So those are very different from the males and not so colorful. But they also eat the nectar, and hover not so gracefully as the hummingbirds, but they do hover a little bit, hang upside down, do a lot of acrobatics to reach to the nectar from the flowers. Let us look at some insectivorous birds. So there are so many types of birds. They have decided what they are going to eat. Like, I'm going to eat fruits, I'm going to eat grains, I'm going to eat insects. So they are all categorized as per their food and feeding habits, and their bodies and beaks have evolved as per their food. Like, this is a black drongo. This is a very common bird throughout India. It has a habit of perching on one particular branch, and when it sees some insect flying around, it just flies off and will catch that insect in the air. And then we have magpie robins, very beautiful singer, which is there in every city. You can see them early in the morning sitting on the corner of a top building or a tall building or in a power electric pole and singing beautifully. So the male is beautiful and has a blue shine, and the female is slightly dull in color, and makes nests in holes in buildings. And similar looking bird, Indian robin, but it has an orange vent like this. And again, the male is more beautiful, but it doesn't sing so beautifully as the magpie robin. And this is also a bird which stays around human habitations around our houses. And they all feed on insects. There is one bird which is many times called as woodpecker by the villagers, but it is not a woodpecker. And it is the hoopoe. And it has got a beautiful crest and loves bugs and earthworms and caterpillars hiding in the soil or leaf litter, and moves around and hops around your houses. So this is a common hoopoe. And we do have Indian roller, or we call them in Nilkant. I don't know, what do you call them in Uriya? Can you type? So beautiful bird. Nilkant means the kant, or throat is nili, means blue, but it's not like that. So see this photograph, the wings are blue actually. In Marathi now we have named it as Nilpankh, that is blue wings. So such a beautiful bird when it fly, and it feeds on insects. And if you go to any agricultural land or cultivation, you just look around the power lines, or if you are traveling in a bus, look around on the power lines. You can see this bird sitting on the power lines and catching insects around. So they're very important controller of insects in the agriculture. And the name of the bird itself says it is a bee eater. That means it's honeybees. It eats honeybees, that is true, but it also feeds on lots of insects and can catch any flying insect. And it has got a beautiful, beautiful line, just like an eyeliner or kajal. So that is to help it to fly against sunlight, toward the sunlight, so that it can catch an insect which is coming from the sunlight and catch it. So that helps it absorb the sunlight, just like it has got ribbon goggles, or you have got a hat or a cap. So that helps. So it is a very very intelligent bird, and very nicely catches the insects and then bangs it on the perch and kills it and then finish. If it catches a honeybee, it removes the stinger, so the poisonous stinger, because the honeybee, if it is alive and if it is not killed properly, and if the stinger is not removed, the honeybee may sting inside the throat or inside the stomach. So mind it. So that bird is very intelligent. It understands that a honeybee has a stinger. Then we have got two little cute birds moving around our houses, in our gardens, in our backyard, and one of them is common tailor bird. This bird keeps on shouting like chibik chibik chibik. It makes a beautiful nest which is stitched just like a tailor. It makes stitches, beautiful stitches, just using cobwebs, spider webs, or whatever is available in nature. Even if you throw some cards, it will use those cards and help in use it in sieving the nest, which is made from one leaf or two leaves stitched together, and there is a small opening from where the parents will feed the chicks. Very tiny bird and beautiful bird. One more bird which looks very similar, but like the upper side is ashy in color, that is known as Ashiprinia. This also keeps flitting in your garden, and both eat small caterpillars, small insects, mosquitoes around your house, and keeps your area clean and takes care of your health because it eats lots of mosquitoes. And there are some birds which are vegetarian as well as non-vegetarian. And so when there is a question what to eat, they say yes to both. So those are known as omnivorous birds, or which feed on both type of food. And the best example is our own neighbor, that is the crow. And what do you call them in Oriya? Cow. So this is the house crow on the right side, and the total black is the jungle crow. Yes, cow. Yes. And in Marathi, when we are young, we call them cow. Okay. So these are very intelligent birds, except in front of the quail, there where their intelligence doesn't work. Otherwise, they are very intelligent birds. In the sense, if you torture them, they will remember you for 1 year, and they will torture you for at least 1 year. So never torture, never try to trouble a crow in your area. Otherwise, they will remember you for 1 year. Not only they will remember you, they will tell all the crows in 1 kilometer area that you are a bad person and you trouble birds. So, and all the birds will try to peck on your head and take your revenge for 1 year, at least 1 year. They have very sharp memory, and they remember faces, human faces, very well. So you might have to hide your face, use a mask like Corona. So very intelligent birds, house crow and jungle crow, except in front of the quails. They raise the babies of the Asian quails or the parasitic cuckoos. Otherwise, they are very intelligent, and they remember. They have a very sharp memory. They are very social birds. They love playing. They travel on buses sometimes. So they are very intelligent birds, and the jungle crow also knows how to hide food so that it can eat it tomorrow. Okay. Then one more bird which is there around your houses is the red-winged bulbul. And what do you call it in Odia? Bulbul, we call bulbul. So red-winged bulbul. So beautiful bird which feeds on fruits as well as caterpillars. Okay. And makes a nest in a garden, very open nest. And okay, gobara is there, yes, and bulbul also is there. Okay, very good, good, great. But there are two types. The first one does not have a crest, and the second one, let us go back. So it doesn't have a very big crest, tight crest, and it has a red vent. But the second one doesn't have a red vent, it's slightly oranges. And the crest is bigger, and of course it has got a red patch on the cheek. So that's why it's known as red whiskered, but it is not whisk, it's the cheek, okay. So these are very beautiful birds, and they go on singing throughout the day and go on calling throughout the day. That's why they are known as bulbuls. Ham bulbule is ki o indosata hamara. That means we are all chirping birds like bulbuls. Then we have a few more omnivorous birds, and they are known as maina, and that's known as bunny, and very in Oriya, and very common around your houses. Feeds on rubbish. If you throw pieces of roti, they will eat. If you throw rice, they will eat rice. And if they get caterpillars, they will eat caterpillars. Then the Asian pied starling, again, beautiful, just like the mynah, but slightly black and white or pinkish in shade. And the third one, which has got a hairstyle just like Sanjay Dutt, that's the Brahmini starling. When it moves its head, the hair will stand up. And long hairs like this. So I always say this has got a hairstyle like Sanjay Dutt. That is a Brahmini starling. And we have got a bird which is known as jungle babbler. So this is also known as Sat Bhai in Hindi. But in English, it is known as seven sisters. So in English, sisters are more important. In India, Bhai is more important than brothers, sisters. That's how we look at it. We should also call it as Sat Behen, seven sisters. So these always say stay in flocks, big flocks, and they make, all of them will make one nest together. Not seven nests, one nest, only one nest. And there are eggs inside, everybody protects, everybody feeds the chicks. That's how they work. They are all like brothers and sisters. Oh, there is one very interesting bird, and this man wanted to tell us why this bird is very important for us. And this bird, already the name is mentioned there. Okay, so the bird, it was a very huge brand was created around this bird, and that's a kingfisher. This brand was created around it. So he wanted to stress with this mineral water that kingfisher loves fresh water, clean water, and we should keep our rivers clean and not throw garbage in rivers. Otherwise, we will have to buy this mineral water every day, even for drinking water. So if you want fresh water, if there is kingfisher, it says that the river is not so polluted. Once the river is polluted, the kingfisher is gone. That's very important. This is what he wanted to tell us. This fellow, he created Kingfisher Airlines, Kingfisher mineral water and wine, everything. Unfortunately, this kingfisher flew away from India. That is Vijay Mallya. So I'm talking about the fish eating birds. And I know many in Odia, many boys will be like kingfishers because they also love fish. In all coastal areas, people are kingfishers. They love fish. So this is a common kingfisher. You can see it coming out so happy. Dive in water, get a fish, come out and enjoy the fresh fish like a kingfisher. And this is a small video about how I'm sorry, slightly internet is slow. Okay, I don't think it will play because I have poor connectivity. I can stop my video, okay, for my own video, so I get better bandwidth. Okay, let's skip the video, and I'll just talk about two very common kingfishers. And first, this one is the white-throated kingfisher, very common throughout India. In Odisha, you can see around your house. In it also hunts for insects and lizards around your house, around in gardens, agricultural land also. And the common kingfisher, of course, stays with fresh water with rivers and stays in wetlands or small lakes and ponds. Then after the fish eating birds, let us look at few of the birds of prey. Birds of prey is the birds which feed on other animals. And this is a very common bird, Shikra feed. You can see it feeding on a garden lizard. And then we have the black kite. And what do you call a black kite? Those are the kites which fly in the skies and in cities like Mumbai. There are thousands and thousands of kites in Mumbai. So they feed on garbage. They are numerous around chicken shops in Mumbai. It is a raptor or a bird of prey, but it also feeds on garbage. Chila, yes, Chila is the name. I know. Chila, beautiful name and that's why also known as Chil in Hindi. So this is one of the scavengers. Besides, it also feeds on living prey. It can catch lizards and snakes. And Shikra is found in cities, also feeds on small prey like the garden lizards and even small birds like the laughing dove, spotted dove, the sparrows. So these are the birds which feed on flesh. And there are some birds which feed on flesh, but they fly in the night. And those are known as the nocturnal birds or the night riders. And here you can see is a pecha or a barn owl. And this barn owl hunts in the night. And I'll come back to barn owl after the spotted owlet. And that is known as spotted owlet. And what it does is, it's like many of you. So they keep awake in the night and they sleep in the daytime. So they keep, you can see those boys who did not sleep in the night, you can see them yawning in the classroom in the daytime. So those are the owl characteristics. Okay, they sleep in the night. They sleep in the daytime and they are awake in the night. So they find their food in the night. And the pecha, the barn owl, is one bird which is a real friend of humans in the sense it kills so much of rats and mice in the world that they really save all our crops. And if they are not there, all our crops will be doomed by the rats and mice just because they can reproduce so fast that there will be millions and millions of mice on the planet. And they will be killing all the rats and they will be eating all our crops. So if you have barn owls around your agriculture, that means the crop will be saved and that means you will get more grains. More grains means more money. More money means goddess Lakshmi. So that's why barn owl and all owls are considered as vehicles of goddess Lakshmi. You can see an owl here. This is a poster, Diwali poster I downloaded from the internet. And sometimes people fear owls, saying that they are aliens. And this news came in newspapers a few days back. And it was so funny. These are barn owls standing on their feet and not any aliens. So my friends, birds are very important. And before I started this talk, the ma'am was talking about birds and ma'am was telling, hey, see, just summarize what I was going to say, that birds are very important because they are pollinators of birds. They are pollinators of flowers and crops like sunbirds. They are very important in seed dispersal, like the fruit eating birds, the hornbills are very, very important. There are some birds which control pests like rats and mice. Then scavenging birds like crows and vultures. Then some birds have cultural value like the peacock. And of course the food chain is very important. So sunbirds help in pollination. Hornbills, you might be wondering sometimes how this tree grew here. Because the hornbill ate the fruits and it just passed its poop on our property on this building and the tree started growing and it became huge because nobody was there. Nobody was staying in this building. So this is an excellent example of seed dispersal and seed germination by hornbills and the pest control. Mosquitoes are also eaten. These cattle egrets help in controlling some pests or ectoparasites on the bodies of the cattle. Bee eaters and eat a lot of insects. And scavenging birds like these vultures, crows and kites, they finish up the dead animal, the carcasses of dead animals lying around villages and clean our villages. That's why they are known as shaguna. Means bring good fortune. Then they are part of food chain. Means there are many birds which become food to others. That's why they are important. And cultural value, of course, we revere many birds like the peacock. You can see the peacock here. And you can see the barn owl here. And then Garuda and Saras, so many birds. And recreational value. We started with bird watching. How bird watching can bring a lot of money and how bird watching can give you a lot of happiness. If you just go out on a Sunday and watch birds, you will be happy. Just like me. And I wanted to resign my job because I wanted to be with birds. And if you want to start bird watching, what do you need? You need some good book. And there are two good free books which I have written. You can download these books from Google, 100 Common Birds in India. And birds in agriculture. And how do you identify the birds? There is an Android app. You can download this Android app. This is available for both Android as well as iPhones, iOS phones. So you can download this Internet of Birds. This has been developed by Bombay Natural History Society. So if you click a picture of a bird, you just upload that picture here and it tells you what is the name of the bird in 1 or 2 seconds, and then you refer to the ebook I mentioned in the previous slide, and you can read about it, or you can go to Wikipedia and read about those birds. So I'm sure you will be going out and watching birds. So you don't need to go to Chilika to watch birds. You just look out from your window. There will be crows, and they will be behaving very interestingly. Even the bird behavior is very, very interesting. There will be parakeets, sparrows, and mynas and bulbuls around your house. So start watching them. No need to go to Bharatpur to watch every bird. Okay, make a list of birds. Whatever you see there, the birds are everywhere, and you don't need to really travel long distances. But if you get keen interest in birds, do start watching them. And if you want to be a scientist, to be ornithologist, take more interest, take guidance from your ma'am, that they will surely guide you. And dear friends and teachers, I stop here my presentation. I think it was a little bit lengthy. I hope it was interesting. Thank you, ma'am, for inviting me for this webinar so well organized by you.
Thank you so much, sir, for the educational and informative presentation. That was really a stimulating experience for all of us. We found ourselves familiar to all the birds. We identified ourselves with the flying jewels. And I'll take a liberty in this webinar to just point out to my students, if they remember, a year or two before, I think, a film was released, a movie, Robot 2, in which, because there was a very good message, a very strong message to prevent the birds. You all must have seen, dear children. And after this webinar, and I hope that you'll definitely take all the steps, what is in your hands, and do some favor to the nature, to the birds. Thank you so much, sir. And dear audience, dear students, if you have any queries, please raise your hands and you'll be unmuted, and then you can ask your questions. Please raise your hands for your queries.
Good morning, everybody. Here is Nitish. You can unmute and ask the question.
I wanted to ask that, are the birds descendants of dinosaurs?
Yeah, some species of dinosaurs, like the Archaeopteryx. Yes, you are right.
Next, Om Sai Mahapatra. CDA Katak. Please ask your question.
Is platypus a bird?
No, it's not a bird. It's a mammal. It's a mammal. It only has a beak like a bird.
Thank you, sir.
Yes.
Next, Divya Jyoti Depta, DAB Public School.
Sir, I have heard about a bird that when it makes sound, it is heard up to 2 to 3 miles. So can you please say the name of that bird?
I don't remember, but there is a bird. And in the forest, there are many birds of which you can hear this, hear the call up to 2 to 3 miles. Okay. We have a eagle.
So they are mostly found in Amazon forest.
Yes, yes. There is only one bird. The call is very harsh, and the video was very viral on WhatsApp. But we do have a crested serpent eagle. You can hear the call when it is flying in the sky. You can hear the call up to 2 to 3 kilometers in India itself.
Sir, another question.
Yes. Yeah, go ahead.
Sir, when birds, when chicks or small birds come out from their egg, the thing they first see, they believe that that thing is their mother. Am I right?
Only in chicken.
Sir, then
not all birds.
Sir, what is the name of this characteristic, especially of birds?
It's a genetic imprinting.
Thank you, sir.
Yes.
Next is Gurudatta Mahanti. Please unmute and ask your question.
Sir, if we contribute individually to the preservation of birds, then how can it will affect in a large scale?
No, beta. Can you repeat? I could not understand.
Sir, if we individually contribute towards the preservation of birds, then how it can be helpful in a large scale?
it will be very helpful if every Indian decides that it's going to help the birds. That will be very, very helpful. That's going to help. Yes.
Okay. Next is Rajat Mahapatra. Rajat.
Good morning, sir.
Good
morning. So I have a doubt that if we give wings to ostrich, then can it fly?
No, the legs of an ostrich, the bones are very heavy, and the body is also very heavy. It is already evolved not to fly. All other body structures are evolved in such a way that it can run faster, and it has heavy strength in the legs and not in the wings. Even if you give wings, the wings should be more than 12 feet or 20 feet long, wingspan. Then only it might be able to fly. Otherwise, no.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, Rajat. Next is Anurag. Anurag, please unmute.
Sir, kiwi is a small bird, but their eggs are very large. Why?
Yeah, ground nesting. It is a ground nesting bird, just like chickens. But the eggs are not very large. Actually, in proportion to the body size, they are okay.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Next, Adhyasri, unmute and ask your question, please.
Good morning, sir. Sir, as you have explained that, you have told when the chicks see a toy hen also, they think them as their mothers. So if they will see us as the first, so they will think us as our mothers?
Yes.
Sir, it's real?
That's why when hen is always kept in a box for incubating the chicks, okay, and nobody is allowed to go near to the cage. Yeah, if you know how they incubate eggs of chickens, you are not allowed to go near to the cage when the chicks are supposed to hatch. They hatch in 21 days. So on that day, nobody goes nearby. Otherwise, that creates a lot of problem for the chicks. There is a hell of confusion.
Thank you, sir.
Yes, welcome.
Next is Anshuman.
Sir, as I have heard that, sir, that birds have holes in their bones, sir. Why?
No. Can you repeat?
Yes, sir. The birds have holes in their bone. Why?
No, I couldn't get.
Sir, why do birds and bird bone have holes?
Birds make holes.
Bird bone. Why there are a hole in the bone of the bird?
Oh, the bird bones are they have holes because they want to make the bones light. So inside the bones they have got small air sacs. So the bones become light so that it becomes easy for them to fly. If the bones become heavy, they won't be able to fly. That's the reason.
Next, Satyajit Kar, DAV Jajpur Town.
Good morning, sir. Sir, I am Satyajit Kar of Class 8 of DAV Public School, Jajpur Town. Sir, I'm asking that, sir, is there any bird which don't sleep at night?
Owls, all owls. So many owls. So many owls. And some students also. There are owls. These are known as nocturnal birds. Owls, nightjars. Then there are frog mouths. These are the nocturnal birds. They don't sleep in the night. They sleep in the daytime. Okay.
Sir, another question. Sir, while sleeping at night, sir, switching of lights promote good sleeping of birds. How?
Internet is. Repeat your question, please.
Oh, yeah. Near the village, there is a big heronry. Heronry means a lot of. Yeah, no, he's saying why switching of lights is good for birds. So, if there is a colony of birds or birds are sleeping on a tree just outside your window, and if you keep all the lights switched on throughout the night, the birds get confused. Especially in Mumbai, there are birds like fantails and robins who start singing at 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock, any time in the night, thinking that it is day. It is daytime. So these birds get exhausted. So it's not good. But unfortunately, you cannot... I can switch off lights in my house, but not the street lights. So that is what is happening. I hope the birds are adapting or what is happening, I don't know. But the breeding success means the number of chicks which come out are less in these birds because they are already exhausted in the night. So that's why it's good. Yes.
Next I will come Kriti Sahu from DAB Baleshwar. Unmute and ask your question.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
Sir, my question is that does the health of the flying birds are affected by the high frequencies of signals?
No, there is no evidence.
Sir, but in robot 2.0, it has been seen.
If the evidence comes out, that will be available to us.
Okay, now I'll ask Ayam Mandal from DAB Co.
Yeah.
Good morning, sir. Sir, I am Ayam Mandal from DAB Co.
Yeah.
Sir, I want to ask Dad, sir, why the house sparrows make their home in the house of the peoples, but why not other birds?
That's an evolution. See, it is also if everybody wants to make nest at one place, there will be fight. So long, long ago, all the birds, when they were evolving, everybody was trying to find a home. Okay. So the birds found that there are no birds making nests in human homes. They made their homes. So that's how they evolved. So they also evolved to stay with humans, feed on grains. So make nests in human houses, in the crevices, behind the photo frame, even on the ceiling fan. Everything which humans have, they accepted. They started accepting, and they evolved like that. So that was a successful strategy. So they are still there.
Thank you, Ayam. Next, Anidhish Nayak, please ask your question.
Good morning, sir. I am Anidhish Nayak of LRDV. Sir, my question is: what is the average lifespan of a bird?
Some birds live for a few months, but some birds, there is no average actually. The average can be for one species. There are some birds which live up to 50, 60 years, like vultures and flamingos. It has been proved. Now we know there's some flamingos can live up to 50, 60 years. My teacher had a, and that time his daughter was also 1 year old. So that parakeet survived up to 28 years in his house. By the time his daughter had already married and he had grandson. So the parakeet survived for 28 years. So it depends on every species. Smaller birds live for smaller duration. Larger birds survive for larger duration.
Next is Navaprabhat Swain. Navaprabhat Swami, please ask your question.
Good morning, sir. Sir, why birds migrate with group?
Birds migrate because they have problems at their place where they are staying. For example, if you don't get job in your town, you will go to other town.
Like, no, sir, in group. Why in group?
No, just wait. Let me answer. So there are birds in Siberia where... the 4 months are very good in Siberia or in the Himalayas, top Himalayas, like above Uttarakhand, high altitude Himalayas. Because there is snowfall as soon as the winter arrives. When there is snowfall, everything is covered and the trees also lose their leaves. There are no fruits. There is nothing to eat. And there is too much of cold. Okay, cold is not a problem, but there is nothing to eat. What are they going to do? So they start flying. Now they know where they are going to fly because for generations they are flying. So when they are flying, it's not good to fly alone. So they fly in flocks. So first they make flocks and then they fly in flocks. Now with generations and generations of experience, they know where to fly. So every year the same birds fly to the same place and at same season, same date. And on the same date, they start journey back to the same place where they were born. like a bird from Siberia comes to Bharatpur or to Chilika, the next year also it will come to Chilika again on the same date, nearly same date. And the same day it goes back to their Siberia. So this is known as migration. So it is, if they are in flocks, there is safety. Okay, if it doesn't answer, so that means when the situation is bad in Siberia, they will go to some other place. And when the situation is very favorable in Siberia, by that time they reach there again. So they know that they have that time clock in their brains. When is the right time in Siberia? And when is the bad time in Siberia? So they have to go to some other place. So now they know where they are, they have to go. Here they go to the same place. Okay. Now you, if you are not satisfied, you can now ask the next question.
Now Sibans Dubey. Sibans Dubey.
Good morning, sir. Sir, I am from GMR Varalakshmi DAV Public School. Sir, my question was that, sir, as you said that ostrich cannot fly. So, sir, can the hybrid variety of ostrich be made to make them fly?
Why do you want to make complications? We can't do anything. Yeah.
Next, Tanishq. Tanishq Chandrakant.
Yes, good morning, sir.
Good morning.
Sir, I am from GMR Varalakshmi DAV Public School. Sir, I have three questions and I wanted to ask that how can I keep the birds from flying into my windows?
Oh, you put a net outside. yes. The glasses look like sky. You change the glasses. You can use the semi-transparent glasses. So that will give you light also. But don't put the shining glasses. No, that is very dangerous. So birds keep on banging and the owls and many birds die. Or you put a net outside. Okay, that is good. Or change the glass.
Sir, what do I do with an injured bird?
Oh, if you are not expert, there are many organizations known as or NGOs which are there for working for bird rescue. So you call them, or if you, first thing is, if it is a chick, don't lift it because the parents are around. So the parents will take care of the chicks. So you are not supposed to touch them. If you get an adult bird which has fallen from a tree or this, then call these NGOs which are working for bird rescue, or take the bird to a veterinarian and hand it over to the rescue organizations. Okay. As long as you don't have any experience, they will save it.
Okay, sir. Sir, another question I have. Sir, do birds fall sick when they get wet?
When they get wet? No. Birds take bath. When the first rains come, they all come out and sit on wires and they enjoy the rains. They enjoy so much. Yes, it's a part of the nature. It's a part of the nature. If they all get, they all would have died. Don't worry. They love taking bath. We should also take bath.
Next, Manjushri from DAV Kalinganagar. Manjushri Mahanti.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
I'm from DAV Kalinganagar. My question is, like we say the rearing of silkworm as sericulture or of plants as agriculture, what do we call the rearing of birds?
Poultry.
Very simple. Okay, next is Soumya Ranjan from DAV Puri.
Good morning, sir. So I have a question that the family of pigeons are increasing, but they are causing the diseases. What are the precautions should be taken by the government to decrease the diseases of the pigeons?
The government, they can declare that those birds as pests, or the government can announce fines for feeding pigeons, and it should be executed. So people stop feeding, and there should be a media campaign not to feed the pigeons. So what will happen? The excess population, inflated population, which is unhealthy, will come under control, and the birds will remain. Okay, so that will help.
Next is Chitrankan Saswai.
Mm-hmm. My name is Chitrang Swami. I am from DAV College. My question is, why do you pick the bees?
No, I could not hear.
Why do woodpeckers peck on the trees?
I'm just looking at the screen.
Sorry, I could not hear. Sir, can you repeat if you have understood?
Yes, yes. Actually, voice is breaking.
Okay, we can take next question.
Yes, sir.
Sir, why?
Yes, continue. Continue your question. If you're next, I will invite Dibyansu Das, Tata DAV.
Sir, my name is Dibyansu from Tata DAV Public School, Jodha. So my question is, does bird get affected by the radiation that are emitted by the mobile towers?
There is no evidence, but we scientists are working on this aspect. Let us hope some solid proof comes out, either in favor or in or against it. Right now, we don't have any evidence. Okay.
Okay, next is Saunak R. Sarangi, DAB Unit 8.
Good morning, sir. My name is Sonek Roshan Sarangi from DAB Public School, Kalinganagar. Sir, my question is, why cranes fly in a V shape?
Oh, that gives them advantage of reducing the resistance against the air. Okay, and this nearmost bird is at the front point or the with the forehead like an arrowhead, so he guides it and he is the most experienced. He has traveled the same distance many times, so that helps. Besides, the air resistance is reduced, so there is scientific evidence that it helps in physics sense. It helps them in flying. Okay, I won't be able to say the scientific terminology really. But it helps them.
Next, Trishamai Pradhan.
Good morning. Good morning, sir. I am Trishamai from Devi Talcher Thermal High School. My question is, why the owls see at night, not in the day?
Oh, they can see in the daytime. They have got so much big eyes. They can see very clearly. Don't worry. But they can see in the night because compared to their body sizes, their eyes are very big. So they can see in the night, but there has to be light. If it is 100% dark, they also can't see anything. Okay. So they can see very well in the daytime. Don't worry. Yes. Next.
There are lots of questions. Next is Lakshmi Priya Gowda.
Good morning, sir. I am Lakshmi Priya from the DAV Talcher Thermal High School.
Yeah. Hello.
My question is, why are male birds more brightly colored than females?
Yes. See, the females are housemakers in birds. Housemakers in most of the species, the female birds lay eggs. Okay, all birds, females only lay eggs, one. But most of the species, the females take care of the eggs, incubation. Only in few species, the males incubate the eggs. So the females has to stay in the nest for a long time and they cannot fly. So now when the female is sitting in the nest, if she is very brightly colored, all predatory birds which are looking for some food will see the female. So she has to be camouflaged, so she cannot be brightly colored. So that's why all the females are dull in color. So like peacock. Peacock is so beautiful, but the female is not beautiful because she has to sit on the ground on the eggs. Anybody, even humans will go and take it if she is colorful. Whereas the male is colorful, it will just fly away. So because you are looking at the male, the female is there sitting in the bush. You don't look at the female because you are looking at the male. So your attention is diverted and you can't see the female which is sitting in the bush on the eggs because of the dull colors. So all these species. So this gives them an advantage. Otherwise, there will be more hunting, more predation, which is known as predation or killing by the predators. So that's why all the females are less colorful.
Next is Mahi Patel, DAV Adani.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
I am Mahi Patel of Adani DP Public School. So my question is, why woodpeckers peck on wood only?
No, they even peck on poles, electric poles. They get confused. They peck on walls also. But their food, which is the termites and insects, they are that those insects are hiding under the bark of those trees. So that's why they peck. When they peck, these termites get frightened. And they put their long tongue under the bark, which is very sticky. So they get all the termites. That is their fresh food. It's like noodles.
Arman Prasti, next.
Good morning, sir. I'm Arman Prasti from DA Public School, Badamba. Sir, my question is, how can we tell a bird's gender?
A bird's?
Gender.
The bird's gender?
Male. Yes, sir.
Oh, the males, in many species, the males are brightly colored, the females are dull in color. So, and there are books. So, when you take a picture or when you observe through the books, you can easily say, so the colorful will be more males, the less colorful will be females, except in few species. So, if you start bird watching, you will know which are the species in which there is sexual, reverse sexual dimorphism. The female are more beautiful, only few species. So that also you will know once you start reading books. And there are many species in which there is no difference in male and female. Okay. Especially in birds in grassland. Because in grassland, there is no place to hide. There is no forest. So all the birds are dull in color, the male as well as female. So there is no meaning in having the male more brightly colored in grassland, because there is no cover. Even if the predators will kill even the male. So all are dull in color. All are brown colored birds in grasslands. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Next. Student, there are so many questions, but there is some another surprising for you. There is a quiz competition. Quiz. Yes. I hope we'll proceed for the quiz.
Yes, sir.
All of you wait for some time.
Thank you so much, sir, for answering all the answers so patiently.
Now, thanks, and I appreciate the active students. Okay, so congrats to them. They are very, very, very smart students, I will say. You are lucky you have got such.
Thank you, sir. Yeah. Now, I would like to invite Madam Gayatri Das to propose.
Which quiz?
Okay, I'm so sorry. Now, students, here's a quiz for you. So all of you, be ready for the quiz.
Okay, student, let me tell. We are going to start the quiz in a Mentimeter. I'm sharing one link. So you simple click the link and enter your name with your school name also. And there is only 5 questions are there. So you have to answer all those questions. We will declare the winner also. Then there is another feedback form, which also contain 15 questions. So you can see the chat box. The link is on your chat box. Simple. Click that link and it will ask to enter your name, and you along with your name enter your school name also. Okay. I'll have to enter your name with the school name, students. Only one student have joined, I could find. All of you join quickly, then I will start the quiz here. I could find only one Acha, two. Yes. All of you join quickly. I found three students have joined. I have shared the link on the chat box. You can see the chat box again. Student, all of you join quickly. Within 5 minutes, within 2 minutes, we are going to start. Raju sir, there is only 5 questions, and I hope everybody will wait and see how the students, what they have received.
Okay, okay. Yes, sir.
Okay. Students, now the countdown starts. You can see the question on your screen, and the time limit is only 15 seconds. Yes, 21 students have given the correct answer. The next question is on your screen. Yes, now we will see who has lead and answer very fast. Dibyansu Das from Tata DAV has answered very quickly. Question 2 is on your screen. Thirteen students have given the correct answer. Let us see who is leading in this question. Okay, Srishant Jena now is in the next question is on your screen. There's 5 seconds, 3. Yes, come on, Maina. Okay, 5 students have given correct answer for this question. Let us see who is leading. Sayan Satyapit Satpathi DAV Jaspur is leading now. Next question. Question number 4 is on your screen. 15 students have given the correct answer, jungle babbler. The next question is on your screen. Let us see the leaderboard. The next question is on your screen. This is the last question. The countdown start for the last question. Only 8 students have given the correct answer. Let us see the champion of the quiz. Navdeep Priyadarshini, DAV Unit 8 has got the highest score in this 5 questions. So congratulate Navneet. Navneet, congratulations. Okay, student, this is the end of the quiz. Now I request Jyoti madam for the next proceeding.
Thank you so much, students, for your active participation, and congratulations, Navneet. I wish I was also a student and took part in this quiz, and I can understand that you have understood all the informations, you have got all the informations which were delivered by Raju sir, and thank you so much. And now I would like to invite Madam Gayatri Das to propose a vote of thanks. Gayatri ma'am.
Thank you so much, ma'am. I would request the host to kindly give me a confirmation about the sound check. Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am, audible. It's all crystal right. Clear.
Thank you. So very good afternoon to everyone. I, Gayatri Das, on behalf of Team DAV Chandrasekharpur, deem it a great honor to extend my gratitude to everyone who have helped us in making this webinar a resounding success. At the outset, I would like to extend my heartfelt gratitude to our revered regional officer, cum principal, Dr. K.C. Satpathy, for his motivation, guidance, and unflinching support. I take this opportunity to express my gratefulness to our esteemed Assistant Regional Officer, Madam Sujata Sahu, for her encouragement in every aspect as we grow. May I take this opportunity to salute our respected Chief Speaker of the Day, Dr. Raju Kasambe, Assistant Director, BNHS, Mumbai, sir. Thank you so much for giving us your valuable time from your busy schedule. This Sunday was indeed a well-spent Sunday, sir. Thank you so much for giving us this enriching experience and enlightening our minds. It was a wonderful presentation, very interactive and very, very interesting. So thank you so much, sir. I would like to make a special mention to Mr. Abhijit Malekar, Education Officer, and Mr. Sagar Mahajan, Education Officer, and the team of BNHS for your excellent coordination, and to all the dignitaries from Vasundhara Project Tata Motors, Mr. Binod Kulkarni, the head of Vasundhara Project, for your support. I would like to extend my profound gratitude to our esteemed headmistress, Madam Sanjita Sahu, for always standing as a pillar of strength. I offer my sincere gratitude to all the principals of DAV Odisha Zone 1 for their remarkable presence. A big thank you to all the students and the teachers for showing their interest in this webinar and for your enthusiastic participation. Well done, students. We are extremely proud of you. Ladies and gentlemen, a webinar of this dimension can't happen overnight. It requires meticulous planning and execution, and we are fortunate to have a team of very dedicated and motivated members. Hence, I express my gratitude to our academic supervisors, Mr. Pramod Patra and Madam Niharika Gantayat, our staff secretary, Mrs. Sanchita Chakravarti, members of the Eco Club, and to Madam Isha Ipshita Satpati and Mr. Prasanna Kumar Dhal for the enormous effort and coordination. But last but not the least, very importantly, a big thank you to the IT department for their rock solid technical support. Once again, a big thank you to everyone for everything. Thank you very, very much. Over to the host.
Thank you, Bob. Now I will request all the participants, please on your video. So we will take a screenshot. All the participants, I'll request please on your video. I also request Raju sir to on the video. Abhijit sir. I will request all the participants. There are two feedback forms. One feedback from the students, another for the teacher. I will share in the chat box. Please fill up the feedback form. And all the participants, when will fill the feedback form, automatically a participation certificate will be generated. You will get your participation certificate. Madam Meenakshi Patnaik is taking the screenshot and storing the memory.
So thank you, everyone. Thank you, Dr. Raju Kasambe. Thank you, Raju sir, for this eventful Sunday. Thank you so much, everyone, for your participation. Thank you all.
Dear students, there are three feedback form. One feedback form contain the participation certificates. another for feedback form for teacher, and the next one is the feedback form the students. Student have to fill up two forms, one form for VNHS and another for your participation certificate. Yeah, plus